In this video, you will learn how testosterone, which is a steroid hormone, is synthesized and secreted, and then how we can turn off its synthesis and its secretion. So we're going to begin with the hypothalamus. The hypothalamus is in the brain, and it's near the center of the brain. And what we would like to do is look at the cells within the hypothalamus called the neurosecretory cells. What these neurosecretory cells do is they synthesize and secrete hormones. And when they synthesize and secrete hormones, their hormones are released from the axon terminal of this neuron. So in the testosterone feedback loop, to get the synthesis and secretion of testosterone, we have to rely on the hypothalamus. We have to rely on these neurosecretory cells that are within the hypothalamus to synthesize and secrete a hormone called gonadotropin-releasing hormone, GnRH. Now, anytime you hear about a releasing hormone, they will always be synthesized and secreted in the hypothalamus. That's a general rule of thumb. Okay, so we have the neurosecretory neurons in the hypothalamus that synthesize and secrete gonadotropin-releasing hormone. So once gonadotropin-releasing hormone is produced, then it has to enter into the bloodstream, and it's going to travel down this capillary. And so what the name of this structure is through which gonadotropin-releasing hormone travels through, this is called the hypophyseal portal system. And what the hypophyseal portal system is basically it's a bridge. It's the capillary system through which the releasing hormones from the hypothalamus can travel to the anterior pituitary. So now gonadotropin-releasing hormone has reached the anterior pituitary. Once gonadotropin-releasing hormone has reached the anterior pituitary, it will stimulate by binding to receptors on the endocrine cells that are located within the anterior pituitary. The hormone that is synthesized and secreted by the endocrine cells in this loop is called luteinizing hormone. So we'll abbreviate that LH. So you should know both the abbreviations and the full name for all of the hormones that we will be discussing. So now, once luteinizing hormone is synthesized and secreted by these endocrine cells, then it's going to travel into the bloodstream. And this is the systemic circulation. And so luteinizing hormone, like all hormones, have to travel through the blood. Luteinizing hormone will travel through the blood to the testes. And within the testes, there is a certain cell type there called the Leydig cells. And the Leydig cells, again, they're found within the testes. And when luteinizing hormone binds to the receptors on the Leydig cells then will synthesize and secrete testosterone. So once testosterone is synthesized and secreted from the Leydig cells, it enters into the systemic circulation as well. So once testosterone enters into the systemic circulation, it can perform several different functions. So on this page, we're going to be going through how testosterone functions. So testosterone, once in the bloodstream, can target a number of different cells. It can target skeletal muscle. And when it targets skeletal muscle, it's going to stimulate protein synthesis, which then leads to an increase in muscle size and an increase in strength. Now, testosterone will also target the Sertoli cells that are found within the testes, and this will stimulate spermatogenesis. So what spermatogenesis is basically it's the development of sperm, so that males wind up with mature sperm, which allows for reproduction. Testosterone will also target the brain, so it can bind to receptors within the brain, which then can increase sex drive. Testosterone will also lead to the development of secondary sex characteristics. So just to give you a few examples, boys who are going through puberty start the development of facial hair, pubic hair, armpit hair, etc. Those are examples of secondary sex characteristics that are developed because of the synthesis and secretion of testosterone. And lastly, testosterone will also promote growth and development of the accessory reproductive organs. Now, that's how testosterone is synthesized and secreted and how it functions. Let's look at how we can turn off testosterone synthesis and secretion. So with hormones, we synthesize and secrete hormones. They perform their function, and then we must turn them off. We're going to be turning hormones off using negative feedback systems. So we're going to begin with testosterone. So testosterone, once it's synthesized and secreted, will inhibit the responsiveness of the endocrine cells in the anterior pituitary. So what this means is that testosterone inhibits the responsiveness of the endocrine cells to GnRH. Because if the endocrine cells don't respond to GnRH, then the anterior pituitary will not make luteinizing hormone. At the same time, testosterone will also have an impact on the hypothalamus.